Anyway, good morning, everyone. My name is Helen Davis. And I just want to say it's an honor and privilege to stand before you today and share with you Grace and Truth Ministries. Grace and Truth Ministries. Grace and Truth Ministries is a Christ-centered transitional home for individuals and families in need. Grace and Truth came after 3 years of Bible College here in Colorado Springs. I came out here to Bible College in November 2011. I was a first-year student. I graduated from business school in 2015, I went back home and I started a Charis Bible Studies group. And actually, I was here when the Charis Bible Studies group got introduced. It was by Susan Walker. And I remember when she came into the second year class and told us about it, my spirit just leaped and jumped on her baby, and she had developed that here. So 2015, I went back home and I started the Charis, the Lord led me to start the Charis Bible Studies group. After I started the Charis Bible Studies group, shortly after that, the Lord started sending me families, people. About seven different families came. And the first thing I heard him say is, do not renew the lease. And I said, renew the lease. So, long story short version, seven different families came. Some were losing their homes, some were homeless, some were living in, not good living conditions, and one of them actually was living in a car. So I started saying, Lord, what is this? Now, I've been a landlord for over 20 years, and I've never experienced so many people coming in, inquiring about a place to live in such a short period of time. So I said, Lord, is this you? And I asked him to confirm. He did. And so then make a long story short, because I only have 10 minutes. January 2016, I actually had four families, and that was the beginning of Grace and Truth Ministries. So, that's how Grace and Truth Ministries began. What our mission statement is, to bring healing and restoration to the individuals and families in need through discipleship, while providing safe, loving, and a caring environment. And that is a great mission, because that's what I experienced here coming to Charis Bible College. Being in this wonderful environment, being discipled by so many teachers, by my peers, getting involved with groups, and just the whole environment. It changed my life. So what God has put on my heart, I wish everybody could come to Charis Bible College, but everybody's not going to come. I wish I could put them on a plane and tell them to come. It's the greatest experience. It's life-changing. But they're not going to do that. But God's put on my heart. Now that I've strengthened you, you go back and you strengthen your brothers. So, I guess that's why he tells us to go. They're not coming. Not as many as I would like for. I'd like to see. So, our vision statement is individuals and families transformed by growing in Christ, their true identity, and fulfill God's purpose and plan for their life. Well, I can totally relate to that. That's what God has done. He's changed my life here, again, coming to Charis Bible College, sitting up under the Word. I'm a nurse by profession. I've been a nurse for 25 years. I used to work three full-time jobs. I worked 8 to 4, 4 to 12, a bailiff shift. I don't know if any nurses in here, but you know how we can work. 4 to 12, 11 to 7 Friday night, 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. Saturday night, Sunday, 7 p.m., 7 a.m., and right back at the job again Monday morning for the 8 to 4. I don't know how I did it, but my parents taught me, if you want something, you got to work hard. So I had the wants. I had the wants. So, but as I learned more about Christ and started, I still went to church, and God took me from three full-time jobs to 2.5 jobs, to 2 jobs, to 1.5 job, to 1 job, and actually I left, and I hadn't worked my last place appointment just before I came here at a residential treatment facility for adolescents, children with behavioral and mental issues. And God has had me out here just to labor, to enter into his rest, to learn about him. He's a great preparation time, he's never wasted time. And he's just providing, supernatural, just like Andrew said. And just like we've been learning, just like everybody's been pouring into us, just continue to seek God. And that's my story. So why Grace and Truth Ministries? Grace and Truth Ministries has the potential to teach many people to grow in Christ. As we build healthy people, we build healthy families, we build healthy families, we build healthy cities, we build healthy cities, we build healthy counties, we build healthy societies. Another thing is we have the opportunity to establish God's kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven. We have that power. The kingdom has come and lives inside of us, and we have the good news that the people are waiting for, that they need. These are some of the services that are important to us. Biblical education, number one. Knowing God. God wants us to know him, know who we are in him. That's what we've been taught. That's why we've been discipled. We can go back and bring it to our communities and to this residential treatment, residential transitional housing. Yeah. Food pantry, thrift store. There's so many different things that I see a vision for to do. Financial planning we have done. We've done credit repair for people in the train people up in the credit fair, get their credit right. We have an aftercare thing and so many other things. I want to talk about some facts. The transitional home, it exists. It exists in Westchester County, where I was born and raised. And the thing about Westchester County, it's one of the wealthiest areas in the country. I was like, wow. It's one of the wealthiest areas in the country. But still, we have over 2,000 people that are homeless and over 200,000 people that are going to be needing to be fed this coming year. Yes. But one thing I do know, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things will be added to it. We don't have a homeless problem. We don't have a poor problem. We have a lack of knowledge problem, a lack of understanding of who we are in Christ. So God, that's the word that you brought me out here when I was trying to figure out what to do with my second part of life. My children were getting older. They didn't want to play with me anymore. My identity was in being a mom, and I started asking God, you know, what's next? What am I supposed to do? And he led me to charismatic knowledge. And that's the way he came to come out here. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things. And God has been faithful. He's provided for me. I haven't worked. I haven't been on no social service. There's no food stamps, anything, any government assistance. And God is still restoring. God is still doing amazing things in my life. As I'm sure many of you can testify from your journey out here. But this is a wonderful life. I hear that song, this is living now. So this is my heart, my passion, to get the good news out, because people are working two jobs, three jobs, four, and they still don't have enough to pay their rent. They still don't have enough to pay their rent. I'm living better now than I was doing in the secular world. The word works.
Amen.
The word works. Jesus loves us, and people need to know the good news of the gospel, that Jesus loves us, and he's fighting for us, and he will provide all we need. So, this is the question I want to propose to you. This is the question I guess I want to propose. How many people want to team up with me? change Westchester County forever. I mean, you might not see their faces, you might not be able to shake their hand, but right here in this environment, we can plan, and in our home environment, we can come together as a team, and I bet you might not get your reward here, but in your mansion, somebody's going to say, thank you for helping Westchester.
Okay, great job, Helen. Where's Westchester County?
It's north of Manhattan. It's 45 minutes. It's not one of the boroughs.
Okay, so it's New York.
Yes.
Okay, so are you gonna, is your plan to establish a home and then oversee it? Where you take in residents? Is that what you're thinking?
Yes, to disciple them, to disciple.
Right, but you'll take them in and take care for them and disciple them. Do you have like a timeframe on?
Temporary housing, about 2 to 4 years, just depending where they are. I don't know.
2 to 4 years doesn't sound temporary to me.
Okay, how about 18 months to 24 months?
How about 6 months?
6 months?
I don't, these are just things. Your team can, you know, if your group gets chosen, your team needs to determine that. Sounds like too long to me.
Okay.
How are you going to staff the home?
Well, that's what I'm finding out through the director's training program.
Okay.
These people who I've been working with since January 2016, I'm planning, and I'm thinking that I'm raising up so they can go back and strengthen their brothers and sisters that right now.
And so are you going to buy a home, rent a home?
I own a home.
Okay. But you know, I'm concerned about you.
Okay.
Because this, you know, having a home where you have people in it, it can totally run you down, wear you out. Mm-hmm. So you're gonna have to think about staffing it. I mean, it's a great vision. So I'm not putting roadblocks. I'm just helping you to identify things that you gotta deal with. And then how are you gonna vet the residents? You know, you need to talk about that. And you don't need to, I mean, these are just things you have to identify. But I appreciate your passion. And I believe you're going to knock it out of the park, girls. Awesome.
Yeah.
Helen, you are someone special going somewhere to happen. And so I believe in you. And so with this, now, did I hear right that you had already done this at some level? You've attempted to do this in the past?
I didn't really attempt to do it. My last job was for a nonprofit organization where they had a residential treatment center that was for children with adolescents with behavioral issues, and then a residential treatment facility for adolescents with mental illness. So on this campus, they have the school, they have therapy. It's really a social worker kind of environment, and family supports to come. They have the church. However, the one thing they lacked was the spiritual development, and then the families wouldn't come out. But yes, I worked at that type of place for 8 years.
Would you need any certification with the local governments to run a home with this?
Well, the funniest thing is when I went to Westchester County, I went to the building department, and Lord says, ask, because, you know, sometimes I just talk and I tell too much. But he said, ask them, what can you do with the home? So when I asked them, they said the home can be either a school or a church. So it's set up that it can run as a school or a church, and the community can, it can exist in the community. So that was amazing to find out.
Thank you so much. Great job.
Okay, Kath. And then you guys make sure now as you're going through this that you're identifying those groups that really are, that you really believe in, that you'd like to serve on, okay? All right?